Hi, welcome to QLab TV. I'm Chris.
And I'm also Chris.
Ashworth Cahoon. We are here to talk more about QLab. All QLab, all the time at QLab TV.
We love QLab.
I thought Chris might be able to walk us through this new feature in QLab 5 called the playlist, a new mode in the group. Tell us about the playlist mode of group queues in QLab 5.
We love the playlist. We had a lot of users that were trying to do slideshows and beginning of show music. QLab could already do it, but it required a little bit of extra queue work. And so one of our esteemed coworkers put together the playlist group, which makes doing that sort of thing really easy. It's a powerful tool. And I think that I'll demonstrate it by making a slideshow.
Great.
With some beautiful photographs. I'm gonna start by making a new group queue. I'm gonna click the group queue icon here, go down to the mode tab, select playlist. So I'm switching that group into playlist mode. And then I have prepared a set of images for myself that I can select all of them and drag and drop them right into my playlist group. So if I go into audition mode, which I can do by going to Tools, turn on Always Audition, then I can play the playlist just to show you what it does by default. Okay, so it shows one picture, and if I hit the space bar again, nothing's gonna happen because by default, playlists are meant to operate on queues that have durations. Pictures don't have durations, so we have two options. One of them is we can give all of these pictures durations, all of these video cues that have images in them, or we can change the mode of the playlist. To start, I'm going to give all of these video cues durations so that the playlist will cycle by itself by default.
Gotcha. And that would be similar to if I were a sound designer setting up some pre-show music and I drag in a bunch of audio files, those do have a duration by default.
Exactly.
And that's the playlist by default would play the first audio file, then play the next one, then play the next one.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
All right, so I'm gonna use Batch Edit and Shift Click to select all of these video cues at once. And I'm gonna set their duration to, let's say, 10 seconds each. Now, if I run the playlist, you can see that on the screen, there will elapse 10 seconds before the next cue starts to play.
There we go.
All right. And you notice that when it jumped from image to image, it did so without any sort of crossfade. Mm. One of the great things about playlist groups are that you can add a crossfade between audio files, video files, or images.
Built right in.
Built
so
right in.
You don't have to construct all the individual fade cues that
exactly
you would
right
have before to do the same thing.
Exactly right. So I just click the crossfade box, and you can see that there's a handy user interface for changing the curve of the crossfade. I think it's going to look great without me changing it. I've set the default to be 3. The default in QLab is a 3-second crossfade, and I think that'll work nicely with the 10-second duration, so I'll just show what that looks like for one image.
So it gets to what about how many seconds? About 7 seconds. And then it starts to do the 3-second crossfade.
Yep. All right. That's looking good.
Then gets to the 7-second mark on the other one and does the 3-second crossfade.
Excellent. Okay. You can also add shuffling to your playlist. So every time the playlist goes, it will change the order that the cues are in, which can be handy if you're using a playlist frequently. People do that with pre-show music and also for effects like these so that you aren't seeing the exact same sequence every time. You can also loop a playlist. So if we wanted to have this slideshow running for a long time, for mm-hmm. example, we could turn on looping and maybe auto shuffling, and then it would play the playlist forevermore until we stopped it with a new order every time. Very handy.
And how does it show me? It looks like the cue list looks a little different once you turned on this auto shuffle mode.
Exactly right. I'll toggle it one more time so you can see the difference. When auto shuffle is not turned on, the cues are not in italics. When you turn on auto shuffle, the cues are in italics. And up here in the cue name, by default, it will list what's happening to the playlist. Currently, shuffle, loop, and crossfade are all turned on. This list represents the order that the playlist is going to play this time, and then the next time it plays, the order will change.
Okay.
Something that many people want to do with a playlist is be in control of the timing of when the next cue plays. So even if I have a 10 second long image cue, sometimes I might want to rush the playlist to the next cue, and we've built in a feature for that. If you go into the triggers tab, when you have the playlist group selected, there's an option under if running, a second trigger currently is set to does nothing. But if you look at that menu, you can change it to plays next.
For a playlist specifically.
Specifically for a playlist, this option is available. Now, in QLab, when you hit the space bar, the cue that you have this arrow next to, which we call the playhead, if I hit the space bar, the playhead will leave that cue. So if I hit the space bar again, nothing happens because the playlist is not currently the playhead. If I want the playlist to do something on a second trigger, I need to make it easy to trigger it a second time. As an example, in this case, what I'm going to do is set a hotkey trigger. I know that I believe my H key is available to use as a hotkey trigger. So if I click into here,
hotkey,
and hit the H key, it assigns this cue to be started or triggered anytime I hit the H key. So I'm hitting the H on my keyboard, and you can see that the playlist started. And if I hit the H key again, it switched early to the next photo, and I can keep doing that. Or because I have a duration set on these cues, I can let them run to their normal time.
So it adds, it will go the way it was set up to automatically proceed, but now you've added this hotkey that, because it's already running, it interprets a new trigger as a second trigger, and in this play, you've selected for this playlist that the second trigger means play the next cue, so kind of rush ahead to the next transition.
Exactly right.
On the H key. Can I be fully in control of when those slides show up? If this is like a slideshow, like a PowerPoint styled presentation, can I do it so that it only responds to me triggering it?
Yes. In the playlist queue, if you're using cues which can run indefinitely, for example, if an image queue doesn't have a duration set, so if I set duration to 0, what that means is the image will run until it's stopped. So if I hit the H key,
I get my first image.
You get your first image, and you can see in the cue list that there's no progress bar to tell you how soon it's going to stop. That's because it will only stop when we tell it to stop. But if I hit the H key, it'll move on immediately to the next cue in the list. That'll also work for example, a video or audio cue that is looping on an infinite loop.
Okay.
If you want to move on to the next cue in a playlist from there. What else is cool about playlist? There's a lot that's cool about playlist.
So this is it really gives you a shortcut to build some common sequences of cues with much fewer cues in a much shorter amount of time.
Yes. And this may go without saying, but playlist is also a normal group cue. So if, for example, you wanted to use a start cue from elsewhere in your show to start a playlist that you're using more than once, you could make a start cue and target your playlist. Right now, the playlist cue number is 1. And so, since I have a second trigger set on this playlist, I'm maybe slightly overcomplicating this, but I can run the playlist with go. And if I run this start cue, it will act as a second trigger as well on the playlist.
Gotcha.
So you can use the second trigger option for this in a few different ways.
It does all the normal things that cues can do because it is just another
cue. Because it's just a very cool cue.
Great. Love that.
Playlists. They're cool.
Thanks for watching QLab TV.
Thanks for coming to QLab TV.